Normal healthy sinuses connect to the nasal passages in a complex network of airflow and drainage passages. Recurrent or chronic sinusitis may occur due to anatomic blockages such as a deviated septum, nasal polyps, or blocked sinus openings. However, persistent sinusitis may also be due to issues related to the sinus mucosal lining itself. The sinus mucosal lining is normally lined by cells with hair-like cilia that move in a coordinated fashion to push mucus and debris out of the sinus cavities. Additionally, healthy sinus cavities contain a diverse array of microorganisms that help to maintain mucosal health and prevent bacterial infections from occurring. These good microorganisms are part of the normal, healthy sinus microbiome. When a sinus infection occurs, an overgrowth of bad bacteria overwhelms the normal sinus defenses, leading to pus formation. When antibiotics are provided, it kills off the bad bacteria. Unfortunately, the good microorganisms are also eliminated, leading to a sterile environment. Fortunately, the normal sinus microbiome usually is able to restore itself. However, in some individuals, for unclear reasons, the microbiome is unable to restore itself, allowing for recurrent sinus infections. Not only that, the mucosal cilia can become damaged and immobile, which removes yet another normal body defense against infections. Finally, bacteria can establish a protective covering known as a biofilm, which protects them against antibiotics, rendering them ineffective. Patients who suffer from recurrent sinusitis due to abnormal microbiome, damaged mucosa, and biofilm presence are known as sinus cripples. Treatment typically requires eliminating any protective biofilm along with bacteria eradication with antibiotics. Following antibiotic treatment, immediate restoration of a normal microbiome, usually with sinus probiotics, must be attempted. Any underlying immunodeficiency must also be corrected. Treatment may require sinus surgery, even if there is no underlying anatomic abnormalities to allow adequate sinus access for effective treatment. Although treatments sound straightforward, it can take weeks, if not months, to get the sinuses back to normal for such sinus cripples.